Hello, Scorpio. This is your October 15th to October 31st, 2016 read. For the main read, I'm using the Morgan Greer Tarot. This is the back of them. It's an older deck I've had. Just can't locate the box right now, but it's the Morgan Greer Tarot. And for the advice cards, I'm using the Magical Spell cards by Lucy Cavendish, which I think is a very cool deck. So thought I'd get that right out there and help you with those as well. As normal, I have already shuffled the deck. Oh, we're getting double cards again. Why is that? And another double card. And one for the environment. Right? Okay. Alright. So you and Cancer must have something going on, because that's what happened for them. The overall energy for this is the Two of Pentacles. Which, I feel like it's looking forward to the future. I almost feel like it does have something to do with the Cancer people. Because they're planning stuff. Maybe you're deciding whether you're going to go to the planned event or not. It's interesting. I really do. Like, I'm seeing this ship in the background. I feel like information's coming your way. And it's on that side. So I feel like it's information from the future. Things happening in the future. Thinking about what happened in the past. Deciding what you're gonna do with that information. I feel like there's information coming to you that you're deciding what you want to do with. That's this whole time frame. I'm gonna put the advice cards out. I haven't done that for the other two, but that was okay. Now we have some similarities with Pisces. So all your water signs are getting together today. This is great. We're going to start right off with this, because this is interesting. Information coming to you. That's what we have going on here. The start of it is the Ace of Pentacles and the Knight of Cups. Pentacles is a stable start. It's a good foundation. It's, a lot of times, it's monetary gain. It could be buying a house, getting a car, something significant to you. By that, for example, it has come up in readings before, somebody investing in a pet, a family pet, like between them and their significant other wanted a certain pet, and this was kind of the significant situation where it's kind of like they had to put in a bit of money to get the pet, but it's definitely an investment that they plan to enjoy. You know, not that pets are property. I don't view my pets as property, I view them as family, but that's up to you how you view that. But the reason I'm bringing that up is because I get romance above this with the Knight of Cups, so I feel like whatever you're investing in or going forward with or doing, it's significant with the other person or somebody else, somebody you love. Like, I feel like at the very least, it's making a relationship closer in some respect, and it's significant. The romance card is above here. 99% of the time when I get this card, in this deck at least, it is a romantic connection. These are general reads. So, like I always say, this also, depending on your life, can definitely mean someone who means a lot to you and is very important to you. It does not have to mean a sexual relationship at all. But it can be someone who's very close to you. It can be a best friend, a child that you're extremely connected with, a niece, a nephew, anything. No romantic connection at all, just one that's very important to you and very, very dedicated both ways. Okay, so that's where we're starting. And like I said, I'm getting the pet thing a lot, so something about a pet, like even, like if it's a situation where you're inviting a pet into your house, and, for example, a child of yours wants the pet, you're allowing the pet, but you're both taking care of it, and it's creating a bond with the pet, but closer with you and your loved one, that's a significant part, too. That could be what this card is talking about, building, deepening relationships. Just don't get caught up thinking it's sexual. It does not have to mean that at all. It has come up in other readings, not this card particularly, but other cards that are similar to this, where it's signified very, very strongly that it's just a deepening of a dedicated relationship on both sides. There we go. All right, as we go forward, I feel like We got the Five of Swords here, which means partial regret, partial win. At least in my mind, that's what it means. I'm noticing this guy in the background strongly here. And he has like his hand out, like he's looking for some help. He's looking for a handout. And I'm seeing you as this person here. Noticing that person. I don't feel like that. I mean, if you notice that person's not facing you, but you're aware of that person, I think you're going to be aware of somebody in need. And this came up. It's not touching any other cards, which is interesting. So it makes me wonder if, like, you have a couple different things going on at this time, and this is just another piece of it. There's somebody with their hand out that needs help, and I'm not getting whether it's warranted or not. I'm just not sure. But I am definitely getting that you're aware of it, and you're deciding whether you want to get involved in that. I also feel like, as we go into the next cards, like you may not. We got the, is that four? I'm going to say it's the four. Yeah, Four of Cups and the Four of Pentacles. Where is my brain? Which makes me think, one day I'll talk well. Makes me think that you're paying attention, you're thinking. I feel like that's connected with this card. I feel like almost like that first part is a different situation for some of you. And this is something else. Like, I don't know why we're doing two different situations, but it feels like it. As we go into this next thing with the person with their hand out, I feel like you're watching and thinking and waiting and kind of thinking things over, but you're kind of keeping to yourself a little bit, and that you have a lot. You have a lot of things you could give, but you're not sure about it. Going back to this, I'm almost thinking I know how this connects in. It might be either the same person or the same type of situation. Either you went forward with a certain situation with one person, and then somebody else also wants the same thing, but it's not quite happening for them, and they're not directly asking you, but you could get involved with that. And you're just not sure. And I feel like part of it is you're not sure you have the resources to do so. I'm also getting that you do have the resources to do so. I feel like you have more to give than you may be aware of. I don't feel like this. I don't feel like you're being miserly. I feel like you're just like. I feel like you're kind of looking at it in the sense of like, do I want to really commit to this again to another person? Like, I'm already doing this once. Do I want to do this twice? I'm kind of feeling like that's what's going on. So you're committing with some person on one level in the very beginning, and then due to that, you're kind of questioning whether you want to help someone else as well. So this is how it comes together. Okay. I am getting, though, that you could if you wish to. I feel like you may not. I feel like you might be a little more conservative, at least at first, and you might just kind of think things over. You may be kind of wondering or questioning whether the second person, the second situation, would really work out as well. I think that's another thing that you're worried about. Like, is it going to be wasted effort? Around you, this is connected more to the second situation. These are the only cards I got for environment, and it's kind of pulling me towards the second part, which for you, that's probably backwards the way I'm doing that, but hey, sorry. This is going like towards the 31st. So the second situation, I feel like we have someone. I feel like they're talking, and they have minimal action. I feel like it's more talk that they want something, and it's related or relatively the same to the first situation you were a part of. I feel like it's either like, if you have a couple kids, it's the other kid, or if it's a situation, it's someone else going through the same situation type scenario. And I feel like I almost feel like they just want to be included, which is interesting, and I think you might know that. And that might be why you're holding back, because I almost feel like you're like kind of looking at it like, I don't really know if that person actually wants to do that. And I feel like in a lot of cases they just might want to be included. Like I just feel like they're trying to almost keep up with the Joneses, if that makes sense. Like they see one person very happy with the situation and they want to be happy too. That type of thing. And I feel like you might be looking at it that way and deciding to hold back for that reason. Because again, I feel like you have the resources to do so. You're just not convinced it's what the second situation calls for. So you're thinking it over. And I feel like, especially like the jam is really prominent to me, which is like very sweet, very good. It's like, all right, you have it on toast and then you're done. But like, it's just, you want that sweetness. I don't know how to explain it. Like you want, whoever it is, this is environment, by the way. The sweetness is, like it's just being attracted to the sweetness. How do you explain that? Like a quick joy, a quick, just like you have some jelly on your pancakes for breakfast or something. Like it's very transitory. I feel like, and that's how you're kind of looking at it. And it may be that way for them. I feel like they want to be included. They want to be happy too. So either they're looking at the person in the first situation and they want to have the same happiness they do, so they're kind of mirroring the same situation. Or it's another sibling or someone related to that person or related to you. And they're realizing the other person got it. Why can't I have it too? Like, just kind of keeping up with the Joneses. And I feel like that's how you're looking at it. Like, does this person, the second situation, is that really what they want? Or do they just, you know, feel like they're owed it, type that. And I feel like, I hope that's a smaller portion of people that happens to, but I feel like that's how you're kind of looking at it, like, eh, I could, but I don't really think they want that. They just kind of want the attention. Like, especially that handout going on there. Okay, so the overall energy here, information coming towards you. When you first get into this situation, I feel like there's a significant purchase, significant building block. Even if you don't actually purchase, like if it's an animal coming into the life and it's a stray, but it's like it's a significant building block, like an addition to the home. It's an addition to your life. I feel like that first part goes very well. You're very happy. It's a good thing. It's a deepening of a relationship with someone that you're helping them out, or you're making that decision together to have that. There's a second situation where somebody else also wants something. I don't feel like they're coming to you directly, but it mirrors the first situation in some respect, and that you're seeing it for kind of what it is more and more thinking, that they just want to be included too, they want to have the same joy, and you're kind of viewing it as like, do you really want that, or you just want the attention? And you're kind of holding back and thinking things over for that reason. I feel like you could do it, but you're just kind of like wondering if it would be wasted effort, wasted money, wasted funds, blah, blah, blah. So you're kind of holding off, which I'm viewing personally is a smart thing. I'm not getting any information that says otherwise, so I'm thinking that's a smart thing to do. Just to like watch, see how it pans out. Because like I said, you could. I just don't feel like that's where you're going. And you could definitely do it though. So of course, feel free to leave me comments below. I always love to see the comments. If you want a personal read from me, shoot me an email, james4astral@gmail.com. That's james4astral@gmail.com. Thank you.